Hi, my name is Evelyn Ayre, and I'm a conservation intern from Queen's University in Canada. Today I'm going to talk about our lovely Bruker M1 Maestral XRF machine, that's X-Ray Fluorescence machine, and I'll talk to you a little bit about the theory behind XRF. So when we use this XRF machine, what's happening essentially is that this machine will fire a beam of X-ray radiation at the object that we choose, and on an atomic level what happens is the electrons that are close to the core of the atom are excited and ejected out, and the outer electrons of this atom will compensate for this loss by dropping down to a lower energy level. And when this happens, the electron, because it's dropped from a higher energy level to a lower energy level, will release some energy in the form of a photon, basically. So when we use this machine, effectively what's happening is that the machine is reading this ejection of energy that's produced by the electron dropping down. So the first step when we use this machine is to do a calibration for the machine of a known standard. So in this case we use a silver calibration, which is a known percentage of silver, and this is used to calibrate the compositional analysis software, which allows us to then determine what percentages of different elements are in whatever objects we're testing. So it improves the accuracy and precision of what we are measuring. So here we have our known standard, and we're going to use silver, which is right here. And then we raise the platform so that the object is positioned at the right level for the X-rays to be read. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is actually take a measurement of a bit of gold on an object that I recently conserved. This is K1010. And I'm interested in seeing what the composition of the gold of the filigree, as well as the gold sheet on the back, as well as perhaps some other areas on it. But I'm going to start with the gold sheet first. So here what I've done is I have placed the object in the machine. And on the screen here you can see the object, the area that we want to measure is in focus, and we have the crosshairs indicating where we're going to be taking our measurement. So this is the spectrum that's produced by the X-ray fluorescence. So what we can see from this spectrum is that the machine has figured out the composition of this gold sheet that we have tested. It is a 21 karat gold. It is made of almost 88% gold. There's about 7% silver and about 4% copper.